Thank you. Thank you. It's dark out, and he's alone, in the forest close to the dorms. The weather is nice, despite the cold breeze of the winter season. Sergio stares into the darkness, with his phone as a flashlight to guide him through the tangles of the trees, a natural beauty to behold. But suddenly, the light fades, and he is left to see a shadowy figure. Shining the light on the figure, it still remains pitch black. But then, Sergio hears a voice from the figure.
Oh, hello.
Sergio tries to remain calm, but seeing that many darker entities of Poppy Valley means some sort of harm, Sergio runs away upon spotting him.
This isn't normal at all.
Sergio screams as he grabs his phone and quickly takes a picture. However, his speed isn't enough to get him any sort of escape, for the hypnotist is always just a few steps behind, and fewer still, all until the very edges of the forest. As the entity runs around Sergio, it is barely noticed that the entity and his darkness are gone. The very edges of the forest. He's almost there. But so is he. Sergio is trapped just as he's about back out of the forest.
Wah, what could you possibly want from me, you damn heathen?
Sergio stutters to the entity under his breath.
No, young one. I have not come to harm you. I am only here because you seek what is true.
The entity replies.
To think just moments ago you were almost perfectly at peace.
Yeah, then I saw you. I know what an entity is when I see one, okay?
Oh, don't call me that. I'm not even trying to be one of those entity things you say are so dark and menacing. I'm only here to help you find the good that is left in you.
Wait, how did you...
Sergio is interrupted by the entity.
I know those feelings deep inside, and they tell me who you are and what you seek.
Proclaims the hypnotist.
Is that so?
Asks Sergio.
Then prove it.
Are you Sergio Sandoval?
Sergio is taken aback. If this is his first encounter with an entity in real life, then he's not anywhere close to ready for what this dark being will say next. The entity continues.
And you have been wanting to find some sort of inner peace? That realization that this world is filled with enough chaos as it is, and the only way out is through? That living the beauty of life while it lasts is more worth it than anything on such a peaceful night like this one? That one must truly connect with the world to find their light in the world?
Sergio is once again taken aback. How did the entity know what is right for Sergio? Sergio stops to think for a moment. He's almost hesitant to agree that this entity is right. At that, so accurate that it shocks him twice, enough for a loss of his own words. After a moment of silence, Sergio faintly responds.
I guess so.
Without any further silence, the entity exclaims.
Well, what don't I know? Why the young one ought to be seeking nothing more, he's in over his head.
Well, what do you mean by that, exactly?
Let me rephrase.
The hypnotist clears his throat and explains to Sergio.
I know you think you're close to finding the truth of all the good in this world. The thing is, you can't just do a half-assed job and expect everything to work for you. You simply aren't treating inner peace like it's inner peace. Nature has its sights, its sounds, and its feelings. But you cannot expect yourself to replicate it without ruining the point of inner peace.
You mean the music, don't you?
Thinks Sergio out loud.
Exactly.
Sergio suddenly understands. All of this time, he has been believing that keeping note of all the feelings he ever had about nature is nothing compared to nature itself. But this entity has let him in on an important answer to most of his questions without even needing to ask them. The comparison does not even work fairly when nature bewilders him.
Oh, gosh.
Sergio nearly faints muttering. Then his voice wakes up again and he asks with a crying tone to him.
How could I have not seen that nature and how to explain it were never the same?
I figured you were like that.
The entity says.
So, how about this? Nature is hard to explain in just one night. How about we meet here again next week, same time, and I can tell you what more you need to know.
I guess I could use some answers if that'll make me happier.
I assure you, Sergio. It will. No need to hold back your feelings about all of this.
brief silence.
Ah, how forgetful am I? I never even introduced myself.
The entity suddenly remembers.
Yeah, you never did, but I guess I feel a bit better already, so I suppose I don't mind.
Admits Sergio.
My name is Gordon. Gordon Todd. And I specialize in neurology.
Sergio nods.
But I also happen to be a naturalist by heart. So, if you ever feel like talking about the universe or the wonders of nature, I would love to hear your thoughts.
Oh, yeah, sure. I could use that.
Great. See you next week.
With that, the entity disappears. Sergio walks back to his dorm under the stars of Poppy Valley, feeling much lighter and a lot less confused. For as long as he can remember, he has always loved nature. He was just waiting for someone to understand the connection between him and nature. Now he knows, and now he feels happy. But little did he know that next week, Gordon would reveal himself to also be a hypnotist.